Hello there, YouTube. Today's Mega Overview is going to be for Mega Audino. Now, of course, in its normal form, Audino is a normal type. When it Mega Evolves, it goes very normal, which is very nice as it gives it an additional dragon immunity in addition to its ghost type immunity. Unfortunately, its ability is more double suited, but that's not to say it can't be useful in doubles, but changing over to the healer ability from Regenerator, not quite as useful there as healer has no function in singles battles. Now, looking at Mega Audino's stats, it actually has the highest base defense of all normal types, I'm pretty sure. Hitting 126 there, he gets a good bump, a 40 point defense bump and a 40 point special defense bump, and then a 20 point bump to his special attack. Now, while Audino is still slow, now its defenses are a little bit overwhelming. It doesn't look like it's that bulky, but with that high HP stat, it's very difficult to break through without boosted attacks. Furthermore, with immunities, it gives multiple opportunities to switch in, and it can recover its own HP via Wish and Draining Kiss, so that means you can't even whittle it down with Toxic. So with the right team support, Mega Audino can be incredibly difficult to take down. Generally, you're probably going to see Mega Audino with Calm Mind or just bulky team support. With base 80 special attack, it can kind of just throw around Hyper Voice or Dazzling Gleam, even without investment, and still put a couple of dents into things. But with Calm Mind, base 80 invested alongside those moves is going to hurt some things after a couple of Calm Minds, and since it can easily recover its HP through Wish and Protect, and since there's nothing immune to Fairy types, you may even see some Calm Mind sets that are just Wish, Protect, Calm Mind, and Dazzling Gleam. Furthermore, it can also recover its HP through Draining Kiss, which is also boosted. But it has a couple of options there. That being said, it's going to be relatively easy to check Audino. You may not be able to outright KO it, but you can certainly stop what it's doing with Taunt. That gives opportunities for other Pokemon, such as Steel-types, which resist both of its Stab-type moves, to come in and set up. Special mention to Metagross here for having access to Agility and Hone Claws. It can set up on Mega Audino relatively easily. And, of course, Heatran resists anything that Audino wants to do and can basically set up on it. So any Steel-types that are in that same vein, that same defensive vein there, Audino could run a Hidden Power to deal with those, but it can't really give up a move slot to afford it that type of coverage. Now, similar to Mega Altaria, Audino really appreciates trappers like Dugtrio and Magneton, or Magnezone, if you're playing higher tiers, to eliminate those steel types by trapping them and getting rid of them with the right super effective move. And actually, steel and poison types make really good partners for Audino as well, just because it can support them with Wish and Heal Bell, while also getting rid of other bulkier Pokemon. Audino can typically outstall things. You might see Toxic on some sets. But Tentacruel and Jirachi, those can both set up entry hazards. They also can both have a decent offensive presence and both have above average speed. So partners like that are going to be able to take advantage of Audino being able to basically wall the opponent's offensive efforts outside of setting up on Mega Audino after taunting it or something like that. So I hope you guys enjoyed this overview. Be sure to click like if you did, and look forward to the next one coming out soon. Later, guys.